Good morning, Pastor.
Good morning, Michael and Gino. What is the good word?
Cold.
Cold.
Ooh.
Frozen.
Solid, yeah. You
caught me in Branson instead of Gainesville, so I get it. I understand. Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. We are going to hear from you today about an extraordinary act of compassion from an unusual source, yes?
Yeah, you are. And I did want to ask one favor of you before I get started on that, and that's, can I wave to Mary Louise? Because I haven't seen her for a few days. I'm speaking at this conference in Branson. So
good luck with the wave.
You're giving a shout out.
You understand we're on radio, right?
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. Okay. Very good.
You know, one of the opportunities that I have with this is to look for grace reveal, to look to see how God is in some of the most difficult of circumstances that we find around there. And what an interesting journey that is to walk that with people, to watch how God is working, not only in the midst of absolutely celebrative and joyful situations, but in the midst of trial. Have you guys heard in the news about the Southwest flight that was held back?
Yes. Yes, yes.
That's the nature of this. And what I did was a lot of research on sort of the backstory of what was happening, and I guess it touched my heart because it was a grandpa. I don't know if you guys knew that. It was actually a grandpa, the little two-year-old that made the news and for whom the flight was held in this whole thing. So it's interesting that as I pieced the story together from a number of different resources, there's a Denver Post, ABC News, Elliott.org, a travel blog, an interesting story develops from this grandpa, and I would invite you to see the work of God in this very troubling and difficult situation, especially from his perspective. First of all, this grandpa lives away from his two-year-old grandson, who I don't want to get into any of the details, but who was really quite tragically injured and would later die from those injuries in kind of an abusive situation. So the first news comes to the grandpa is, as you might imagine, super traumatic as he gets it on the phone that his grandson has been injured and it might be a fatal injury. So heartbroken and torn and in desperate need to get back, you know, and as a grandpa with grandchildren, you know, literally spread around the country, I can immediately sense that separation and how painful that would be and how much you want to be with them.
Right.
So he makes, as quickly as he can, he makes plans to fly, but like we've all experienced, his first obstacle when he arrives at the airport is a long security line. So here he is in a desperate attempt to try to be with his daughter and apparently at this point in time his dying grandson. And security really isn't being cooperative according to the stories I read. And so he's greatly frustrated that he can't make it through and they won't let him to the front of the line. So he's trying to rejoin. He's trying to be a part of this very difficult situation and being thwarted and frustrated. He finally does make it through security. And in the meantime, he's unaware, but his wife actually calls Southwest and through a couple of different connections makes it actually to the gate agent and the gate agent to the pilot. And the pilot actually exits the aircraft and is waiting for him at the gate. So Southwest has made just great publicity and news. And he sees this. Imagine now, if you will, again, from the grandpa's perspective, the sheer delight in discovering that this flight has been held, that he's going to be able to make this connection. And indeed, he did. He did make the connection and was able to be with his daughter and his dying grandson and say his final goodbyes. And as painful as that story is, in the middle of that is this reconnection. And I think the grace of God revealed in the work of this pilot. And the quote I found here was just absolutely fascinating. Apparently, the pilot waiting at the gate agent, waiting with the gate agent at the top of the jetway, begins to walk down the jetway with the grandpa. And he's very effusive with his thanks going in. And the pilot responds, don't worry, they can't go anywhere without me. And I wasn't going anywhere without you.
Yeah, I mean, you don't hear that those kind of stories often from airlines. We have so many negative things to say about our airlines. But in this case, it was a pilot who
phenomenal
did something that maybe goes around the rules. It takes protocol, sets it aside for what's important and what really matters. And there's a really beautiful scripture verse in 2 Corinthians. It says, "For just as the sufferings of Christ flow over into our lives, so also through Christ our comfort overflows." And this is just a little example of that comfort coming to this grandfather through, of all people, an airline pilot.
Yeah.
So it's a beautiful, beautiful story of grace revealed.
Yep. And you know, it reminds me too of the way that how typically do policies and procedures get in the way of love and connection and relationship. And here they were set aside. And again, it reminds me too, Gene, of sort of in the New Testament way in which sort of Pharisaical laws were attempts to try to, you know, keep Jesus and sincere and delightful ministry from occurring. And you know, Southwest says, look, we can't hold a flight for everybody. And maybe that is the kind of policy that, you know, people are afraid to break because everybody's going to want a flight hell. Yet they were ready to risk that, right? Yeah. That's the beautiful part.
There's rules of companies, then there's rules of compassion. And we're glad the right rules won out on this occasion.
Yep,
Pastor, as always, Grace Revealed, Somewhere in America, and you're always there to bring it to us. We're really pleased. We are going to move forward, but we hope that your stay in Branson is a good one. And as always, we'll talk with you next Saturday.
Godspeed. Blessings to you guys.
Thanks, Pastor Carl.
Bye now.